Hi guys, it's Jessie here. Today we're gonna watch some clips of this amazing tennis player Emma Raducanu speaking Chinese. I'm so sorry, this video is long due because last time I checked, there was only a like really short 10-second video of her speaking Chinese. I watched it and I was like, that's good, but there's not really so much to talk about. But yesterday, I stumbled upon this 5-minute long video of her speaking Chinese. I thought, okay, let's do this. If you have watched other videos of mine, then you know that videos like this are never meant to be like, he's not fluent, haha, he sucks, she's fluent, okay. No, it's always about what we can learn from them. Emma is undoubtedly a brilliant tennis player and she looks really smart and attractive. This video is for language learning purpose only. So, I'm ready to learn. Are you? Okay, let's play.
大家好，我是艾玛。我想在这里谢谢你们对我的支持，特别是从温网到美网，从伦敦到纽约。当我知道你们看我的时候，我就很开心。我也不想让你们失望。我非常遗憾，我今年不能来中国，可是我明年一定会来打中国的比赛。到时候，我希望你为我来加油。好了，我现在有一个微博的平台了，你可以在这里找到我。再一次谢谢，再见。
大家好，我想说谢谢，我希望你喜欢看我的网球，我现在特别特别开心，但是我们赢了，再见，我爱你。
Okay, I already knew that her mom is from Shenyang, Northeast China. Well, it's impossible not to know, it was on the news everywhere. Some information we can gather from these two videos. First of all, about the fluency. She seems quite fluent, although it kind of looks like these are scripted, especially the first one, definitely written down. Well, there's nothing wrong with writing lines down. I'm just saying that it's not really helping for you to tell someone's fluency. So hopefully in the following clips, we can see more improvised speech to tell if she's able to think in Chinese and speak. Secondly, accuracy of tones. Most of the tones are spot on. I just changed my accent, eh? I'm really impressed by her tones. Only like one or two mispronounced tones in a 50-second speech, so that's like, what, 99% accurate? The tones on these words could be a little bit better. 知道
知道知道
遗憾
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 希望
希望希望
Overall, her tones are really good. Thirdly, about her accent. 她有一点东北口音。先听她的翘舌音。翘舌音有四个知、吃、诗、日。它的知吃诗有时候会变成滋滋滋平舌音。For example, 我是
艾玛，
我是
这里，
我想在这里
这里
支持
支持
支持。
But sometimes her 翘舌音 is back, like in standard Mandarin.For example, 我想说
我想说
我想说。
As for the 翘舌音 r, it becomes e.Like, 让,
让你们
Another interesting feature is that in some Chinese dialects, the 乌 is pronounced as 乌. So when they speak Mandarin, they would subconsciously bring this habit into their speech. Here's a video about Chinese dialects comparison, both in the north and in the south. You can check that out later if you're interested in Chinese dialects. So when Emma was saying 温网, it's almost like 温网
温网
But when she was saying 没网 right after it, I think it was back to standard Mandarin. 没网网
都没网都没网
And then when she was saying 失望 disappoint, it's back to 望 again.
失望
失望
It's subtle but really interesting. Like I said, she's got a little Northeast accent, not that thick, just cute. Next, about the phrasing.These are probably not impromptu, so I can't say for sure, but you can still vaguely tell the English mindset behind it, like
再一次谢谢
Again, thank you. The more natural way in Chinese would be 再次感谢大家 or 再次谢谢大家 In English, the pause after again sounds really natural, but in Chinese 再一次谢谢 The pause in the middle is a little bit unnecessary. And in a second video, she said
我现在特别特别开心， 但是我们赢了。
I'm very happy right now, but we won. Am I missing something? Or she actually meant, I'm very happy right now because we won. Correct me if I'm wrong though, but if she meant what I thought, then it would be, 我现在特别特别开心因为我们赢了。我现在特别特别开心因为我们赢了。因为 means because, 但是 means but. Let's keep watching.
I, at the moment, have just loved spending time with my
relatives. I love her accent.
I think that 我也打乒乓球在那里，他们有很多的乒乓球的地方，从小的时候我就在那里，你拿着可以找到一个桌子，大家都会打、
mm-hmm.
然后我就跟谁都可以打，在公园你也可以找到人。
你太厉害了、
我特别喜欢去中国的公园的时候，他们在那里跳舞，看见大家都挺开心的。
嗯，
就特别，我非常喜欢跟我老去公园，从小的时候我就去过。还有那个他们也有一个特别好吃的冰激凌在这里，我不知道怎么说，但是在这里你找不到。
Perhaps with green tea or whatever.
在中国我什么都喜欢吃，那吃的在那里太好了。我觉得我什么都喜欢吃，但是我最喜欢的就是我特别喜欢拌菠菜、
mm.
还有火锅、
wow.
还有烤肉。
我也喜欢火锅
和拌菠菜。但是我那吃的在那特别特别
辣，
不知道怎么说，有一点辣，但是我不能吃辣的。我看我妈的朋友他们可能吃辣的，但是我不是那么样。
慢慢的 Emma， 我相信你会学会吃辣的。不过 hot pot 火锅is so popular. You know what? In London, it's popular. In Britain, it's elsewhere, it's popular. I mean, in China, it's extremely, extremely popular. 我相信你一定很喜欢吃，但是不能多吃哦。你是运动员啊。
我火锅的时候，我最爱吃的是那个白菜。我妈在家里，我天天让她给我做白菜，因为我不知道为什么，但是我从小的时候就吃很多的。
嗯。那么
还有那个火锅调料，哪里在伦敦你找不到，但是在那里你哪都能找到。
Absolutely.
Look at that. We've already talked about her accent, but I wasn't so sure about her fluency before. Now, this is definitely improvised, and she's 100% fluent. And she's really cute. Did you notice how she said grandma?
跟我老去公园。
老 or 姥姥。It means grandma on mother's side. In the South, we don't say it though. We say 外婆. If you're interested in more vocabulary differences in the North and in the South of China, you can check out this video to learn more. 诶，广东话外婆叫什么？
婆
婆。婆婆？婆婆不是老公的妈妈吗？那老公的妈妈叫什么？
和别人介绍的时候说家婆，自己叫的话就是奶奶。
奶奶是爸爸的妈妈呀，那爸爸的妈妈叫什么？
妈妈或者阿妈。
那不是自己的妈妈吗？那自己的妈妈叫什么？
爸妈，妈妈，爸妈，妈妈，爸妈，妈妈。
We need another video to explain all that. That's so confusing. And off topic, like always.
And you have many more fans in the nation.
我当然想去打中国的比赛了。我想说谢谢大家的支持，我非常开心你看见我打球啊。But yeah, I can't wait to see you and play over there.
Yeah, that's a surprise, you switched to Chinese. Yeah, and because your mom is from Shenyang and you have a lot of the media attention in China, and what do you want to say to the Chinese fans? 不过要用汉语说
我想说谢谢大家，我是一个东北女孩，我妈是东北人，然后我就在那里看看我的家人，看我的姥姥，我就想说谢谢你们的支持，我一定想去打中国的比赛，然后可以看到你见你。
How good you are at table tennis and you like the sport?
在中国你哪里都可以打乒乓球，我就可以在中国在 姑爷可以去打，跟谁都也可以打。我的乒乓球也 不错，但是可以练，然后我就好一点。
哎，我真是觉得我不应该跟你说英语，你的汉语真的是太好了。
谢谢你，不是。
啊，他真的好可爱呀、啊，而且他笑起来的时候特别有感染力。我不知道你们啊，但是我看他说话的时候，我的嘴角就会不自觉的上扬。Not gonna lie, she's really charming. Her smile, her energy, both her Chinese and English accent. You know, it was cloudy outside, but now it's not. You know why? Because Emma's too shiny. That's it for today's video. Hope you learned something new today. I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.